Inside venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. Tonight we've got a good NFC matchup in store between the Minnesota Vikings and the Chicago Bears. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. They go play action here on first down. And Rudolph has it left side. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
Now the Georgia Southern man, this is Jerick McKinnon. And he'll lose yardage here, back to the 15. He lost two there, and it's third down. They tried to run the counter, just that the defense wasn't fooled.
And when they're not fooled, you see the end result. Because what you're doing there, you mentioned the counter. You're using your offensive linemen sometimes to pull or move to influence the defensive front to go in that direction and create the space back in the other side and block it appropriately. But you're exactly right.
And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Mitch Unrein coming in to drop it for a loss of 8. And it'll be 4th down.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense. 6 defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. Defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline. They keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing. The O-line coach will.
And he'll take it just outside the 40. 12 yards on the return that time. And it'll be a short field for the Bears as they take over 1st and 10. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. Setback is Langford. He's going to get the football. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Now Cutler to throw on 2nd down. Dumps it into the flat to Langford. And he's got this down 1 yard or 2 shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end. But running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
They brought in an extra defensive back here, so probably not expecting a run on 3rd and 3.
A good call.
Now Cutler looking to throw. Jeffrey with a catch left side. Week 7 was not that great for Alshon Jeffrey. A season low in receptions with 3 and a season low in yards, 33.
But he does have what may be a season high in the number of quarterbacks he's played with already this year,
that's
right?
That's true.
Jay Cutler, Brian Hoyer, Matt Barkley against the Green Bay Packers. So trying to find a rhythm with any of these quarterbacks, it has to be difficult for him.
And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota.
And on the first drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
Still back there. Wide open receiver complete. It's a gain of 20 that time. And it'll be 1st down Vikings.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
Strong left, strong left, strong left.
Here's McKinnon. And he's got some space here. And he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Well, how many times do we say in this game is speed kills? And it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. And that led to a really nice game.
Here again is McKinnon. And he's going to take this one down inside the 45. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter begins with the Vikings holding the football. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. Second down, Bradford. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. And he's brought down after a good game. A good pickup there, a 22.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
They run it with McKinnon. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
They run once more with McKinnon. And he'll take this one down near the 15. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and four now.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Bradford from the gun on third down. And that is incomplete. He was looking for Adam Thielen there. And it's fourth and four.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
Now Blair Walsh for the Viking field goal. And Walsh able to convert it as his kick is good. And the Vikings have a 3-0 lead. So after slogging through a scoreless first quarter, we have action on the scoreboard. A field goal makes it 3-0.
Well, with these two offenses, we weren't going to stay 0-0 forever, were we? I'm not sure that this opens the floodgates, but I doubt that's the last scoring we're going to see.
Now after the made field goal, Walsh back out to kick it away. Set to return now. Here's Deontay Thompson. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went 3 and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys a little bit jumpy.
You do.
Oh, you understand the same way. It's just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went 3 and out.
And now they have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go 3 and out. I went 3 and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. They'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. So Langford the carry there. Fourth round pick last year with Forte vacating to New York. A lot of the spotlight on Langford.
A lot of running backs have possibilities in Chicago. If he can emerge and eat up carries, I think he'll produce in a big way.
Cutler to Langford on the draw. And some room to maneuver. Jeremy Langford. Touchdown, Chicago. 66 yards, and the Bears have retaken the lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
the concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
After the touchdown, Barth now to kick it away. To return, here comes Marcus Sherrills. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Vikings offense now heading out to take over. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
A 1 yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1 yard gains running the bar? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1 yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a 3rd and about 4 more for a 1st. And now it's a 3rd and 4 situation for the offense. From the gun, Bradford. And this is going to be incomplete. Here's Jeff Locke now. On for his 2nd punt, he'd take a repeat of his 1st. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. So just a 3-yard return following a punt of 45, and the Bears take over. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Here's Cutler to throw. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. 23 yards on the play.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. They'll throw on 1st down with Cutler. It's brought in by Jeffrey. It's a gain of 7, and that'll make it a 2nd down.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who could turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
On 2nd down, here's Cutler. He's got time in the pocket. He's got that one complete to Eddie Royal. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their 1st, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Now the offense lining up first and 10. Now Cutler on first down. Throwing right, and that's complete. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And 10, it's Cutler. And Miller with it over the middle. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now, the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it.
And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Zach Miller, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Bears will extend their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here in the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, they've almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
After the touchdown, Barth now to kick it away. Here comes Sherrills. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
On first and 10, Bradford surveying the field. Looking left side, he's got it complete. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Down Bradford. He's got time. Looking middle, and that's complete. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So as they take it over, we step aside. Now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. Final play of the half. Bradford is going to float this one deep right side and unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. So we have reached halftime here in an 11-point contest. As we'll send you down to Orlando, where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry, this is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. So here's the Bears' offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They built a good first-half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Second and very short here, less than a yard. They keep it on the ground with Langford. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
They'll try to run for the first with Langford. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. Throwing now, Cutler on first down. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. Give him three on the play, and that'll make this a second down. Here we go with second and seven. On second down, Cutler toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Jeremy Langford, the one he was trying to get it to, and it'll bring up third down. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. It's a five receiver set, three to the left, two to the right. On third down, Cutler. And Jeffrey's got it. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
It's interesting how we label routes. You know, some people might call this a hitch. For me, a hitch is a little bit closer to the line of scrimmage, about 1 to 3 yards deep. A lot of people might call this a dig route, going this deep on a third and seven to pick up the first down. Others just call it a stick route. Get to the right point, stick in that spot, and let them hit you with a pass. No matter what, they did pick up the first down.
This is Langford on first and 10. A gain of three, second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Second down following the run. Langford again. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
On third down, Jeremy Langford. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. A gain of four that time as the drive continues.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
So here we go, first and 10 now.
Alert. 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 Alert.
Now Cutler on first down. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Eddie Royal is intended target, and that'll bring up second down. And the seemingly endless drive continues. On second down, Langford. And he'll take this one down to the 36. Give him four on the ground there. They're now left with third and six. Back now at Soldier Field. It's Bears football here. They also have the lead as well as we begin quarter number four. They'll need to get it to the 30 for a first. This is third down. From the gun on third down, it's Cutler. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
Here's Connor Barth for the field goal try. From the left hash, this from 53 yards out. And did he have enough? He did. He kept it online and managed to tuck it into the bottom right corner. And they will stretch the lead now to 17-3. So they settle for just the three there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But three does give them some breathing room and lets them build up a little cushion.
Barth now after the made field goal to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. First down. Left side caught by Diggs. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. Chucks this one away from harm, incomplete. Now it's third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And Charles, a couple extra defensive backs in here on third and one.
Not expecting them to run it at all.
On third and one, here's Bradford. And that is incomplete. He was trying to get it to Jerick McKinnon there. And that brings up fourth down.
On third and one, I think everyone in the stadium thought they'd try and run the football there. But they tried to surprise the defense and hit something through the air. Instead, it results in an incompletion.
Here's Jeff Locke now as he's on to punt for Minnesota. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. This is taken at about the 14. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And out will come the offense as they take over. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. As Chad Greenway in on the stop. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
It's a loss of two, now third down.
He's had a big game tonight, and while no one's going to be overly concerned about that last play, you also know that the offense coordinator does not want to see that happen again. They want to get back to doing what they've been doing all game long.
And you would have to think an obvious passing situation here on third and nine. From the gun, it's Kettler. Finding time. And this is going to be incomplete. And you really can't pin that one on the quarterback, Charles. The O-line, they've got to protect better.
And they know it. That's their meal ticket. They want to take care of the big guy behind them. In this case, they let him down.
Here's Pat O'Donnell now as he'll punt it away for the second time. Sherrills to return it. Oh, he shifts past him. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And out now come the Vikings. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Call it a pickup of seven, and it'll bring up a second down. A good start there on first down. They've got to have this drive.
No doubt about it. Down a couple of scores. They have to find a way to put it in the end zone. Chunk plays, explosive plays. That will be the key to this drive.
Ready. Blue 45. Blue 45.
Second down, Bradford. Over the middle here to Rudolph. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Fresh set of downs here. One receiver left, three to the right. On first and 10, Bradford. And his throw's going to be incomplete. A second down throw for Bradford. He's got time in the pocket. And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here, he throws it away. And now it's third. And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. A play fake, Bradford. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Give him 30 yards there. And they're going to speed things up here. First down, Bradford. And that is, I think he caught it. He did, but they'll say out of bounds. It'll be incomplete.
Oh, he caught it. Just couldn't get the feet down. Couldn't get that toe tap sequence, right? I was ready to call tippy toes if that one was completed.
And here comes play number six on this drive. Throwing again, Bradford on second and 10. And this one hauled in by Rudolph. So he got his hands a little too far outside. The ref caught him, threw the flag.
I really don't know where to go with this one. He caught the pass, but in the opposite direction towards his own end zone. That's not one you get every game.
Surveying the field to the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually, it was. It was a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ikey's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Well, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile with their feet. He showed the agility there with a toe tap.
No doubt about it. It's like he'd run to ballet school. Got the toes down and stayed inbounds.
Bradford to throw it. He's going to let it fly. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. They're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
Here we go now. 3-39.
Desperation time. Bradford on fourth down. It's caught. Michael Pruitt. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. The Bears offense now getting ready to take over. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer. Create space for our runners. And let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch. And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. The Bears offense now gets set to head back onto the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
It's Langford, and he's able. Another timeout called by the Vikings now. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. The win for the Bears just around the corner. They go down to a knee. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Victory very much in sight now as they'll take a knee. Cutler kneels on it, and that should just about do it. Here's Pat O'Donnell now, as he's on to punt for Chicago. And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.